Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We thank and praise God for another glorious privilege of coming into your homes or wherever you are to bring you the religious service of the First Church of Deliverance, the Church of Love and Faith, located at 4315 South on Wabash Avenue in Chicago, Illinois. These services are especially dedicated to the sick and shut-in, those who are discouraged, and all those who love the Lord. We trust and pray that this broadcast will encourage your hearts and give you strength to go forward in faith. Our pastor, the Reverend Clarence H. Cox, anxiously waits your communications each week. The telephone number to call is Drexel 37700. We come your way each Sunday at this 11 o'clock hour through the facilities of radio station WCFL Chicago.
Which the builders refused is become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever.
of affliction sweep over the soul, and sunlight is hidden from view. Whenever you're tempted to fret or complain, just think of God's goodness to you. Selection tonight, the choir sings a medley of "Oh, Oh, Oh, What He's Done for Me" and "Jesus, He Brought Me All the Way."
Thank you.
bring you now Margie Jackson and the choir singing The Name of Jesus Is So Sweet.
Thank you.
line, "Give God the glory." Remind you that you're tuned to radio station WCFL Chicago, to the live, non-sponsored weekly radio service of worship, which emanates direct from the main auditorium of the First Church of Deliverance, the Church of Love and Faith, located at 4315 South on Wabash Avenue in Chicago, Illinois. These services come your way each Sunday at this 11 o'clock hour and are under the pastorate of the Reverend Clarence H. Cobbs. If you enjoy our broadcast, we invite you to call us at Drexel 37700, or you may write to Reverend Cobbs in care of the church.
God bless you, my family. On this first Sunday night in January, I'm glad to have this privilege to tell you there's no other name under heaven whereby men can be saved other than the name of Jesus. May I tell you that I love you, and you, even you, and it makes no difference what you think of me, but it does make a difference what I think of you. I cannot allow hate, prejudice, and all the things that separate men from God keep me from knowing, because I know, and I want you to know as I know, that Jesus is the light of the world. Thank you for remembering First Deliverance during this season, and for the hundreds of cards and messages that I received during this season from all over the country. This morning, I attempted to sit and relax, and every few minutes my phone was ringing from somebody who loved me from out of the city, saying, God bless you. Keep on keeping on. Wishing you a happy and a prosperous new year. For your contributions all last year to bring this broadcast to you. And as we venture out on another year, may we broaden the scope of our work. And I'm praying that you will be included in this ministry to help us keep on keeping on. Somebody said to me, what is your program for the new church, for the young folks? I have not divulged it as of yet. I've been afraid because Lucius, Ralph, and Mr. Sloan, and among them, they'll say, here he goes again. But every time I make a step, the Lord has another step. And I have to keep on keeping on. And I'm changing the order of service. I'm going way back tonight. Mike is going to sing first for you. And then Miss Kennedy is going to go way back and sing, my Jesus is a rock in the weary land. He's a shelter in the time of a storm. Come, Michael, first.
Every time I call him, he is
heavy. Sometimes I'm a burden down with care. Always there in time of need, in the time of need. Of need, in my time of need, oh, every time I call him. Of years ago, at 6 o'clock in the morning, we used to sing, "My Jesus is a rock in the weary land, a shelter in the time of storm." Thank you. among the many Christmas cards that I received, and listening to one young lady who was born and reared in this church. She came down to get a New Year light. And now when I came out of the pulpit, she said to me, "I'm going to do better next year. I'm coming back to my church. I'm not much on resolutions. I just like to see you do your duty. You must work the work of him that sent you while it's day. For the night come when no man can work." I just want to tell you another little story about another one of my boys, and I have hundreds of them. Andrew Martin. He said, "I don't get to church like I should, but I don't have a father anymore. You're my father." It was such a compliment. And I have a lot of boys and girls like that. And it says, "I watch over you." It's nice to have somebody to think about you. And I wonder, do you appreciate somebody that thinks about you? That nothing changes their mind. Helen Steiner wrote a little poem. "Give us through the year quietness of mind." And I'd like to pass this on to you tonight in no excitement. I'd like to tell you to get yourself together. "Teach us," she said, "to be patient. Endure something. Don't try to get a lot of new things, but just learn a little patience. Maybe you are better than somebody else. Maybe you don't have any faults like they have. But whatever their shortcomings are, be a little patient." And she said, "Teach us." I want you to say it different. "Teach me to be patient. And always to be kind. Some of you don't know what kindness is. You're digging ditches. You have ugly words. You're ready to say something unkind. And one of the things that it really disturbs me, when folk call me and ask me, 'What do you know?' That's a sign that they want to find out something about somebody else. Teach me to always be kind. And with all the bad, to have something good to say about everybody."
give me a reassurance that the Lord is on my side. Every now and then, I want to know, in the middle of all the criticism and the things that happen, I want to know, are you with me? When everything goes wrong, give me faith to know that everything is going to be all right. Nothing, no darkness, no clouds, no poverty, no distress, no sickness is going to last always. Not even a grave. I don't care who don't believe it, but I don't believe the grave is going to hold us. Amen. Give me hope and give me courage to face tomorrow, whatever might come. Let me be a real soldier. Stand up to it. And know that somehow and some way, God's going to bring us out. And then let me get in the quiet. Shut out all the folks. So many folks aren't going anywhere. Maybe I have to shut off some parties or shut off some social thing, but let me get in the quietness. Glory. And then let me feel your presence. You can. I wonder tonight, do you believe it? I see some folks shouting it don't mean anything. And I don't care anything about folks shouting all the time. But every now and then I want to feel your presence. I want to know.
Yes, sir.
I want you to fill me with something. Fill me with the joy, kin, and peace. Peace on the inside when everything goes wrong. Fill me with peace. Amen. Help me to be real. Don't let me be a hypocrite. Help me to be real. Not just on Sunday, but on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Help me to be real. Can the Lord depend on you? When waves of affliction sweep over the soul and sunlight is hidden from view, somebody will fall out with you. If ever you're tempted to fret, sometimes you'll wonder why it's going to act like that. But look back and see where God brought you from. Bless him. Let's say it. When waves of affliction rise, go forth, ushers.
the father of all mankind. We approach the throne of grace in the spirit of love and humility just to say thank you. You've been so good to us. When we didn't even own you, you was yet good to us, and you protected us from all hurt, harm, and danger. And we said thank you. We thank you because you are our Father, and we are your children. We thank you because we don't wake up of our own, but because you let us wake up. We thank you because you are our strength. You are our life. You're everything that we are. We're that because of you, and we said thank you. Thank you for the church and for what the church means to us. We thank you, Father, for letting us feel your presence every now and then. We said thank you. Thank you for 1977. Maybe we didn't have all that we wanted, but we thank you that you gave us enough. You gave us enough food, and we said thank you. We had a reasonable portion of health and strength, and we said thank you. We thank you, Father. Then we thank you for 1978. Whatever it hope we hold, and whatever it holds for us, we said thank you. We thank you tonight. Bless the preacher tonight. Thank you for him. Thank you for his teaching. Thank you for the choir. Thank you for the songs of Zion. Thank you for the friends who drop by every now and then. Thank you for the 11 o'clock hour. Thank you for the radio station, the engineer. Thank you for the ether tonight. Thank you for every prison-bound person, everybody in the hospital. And we pray for every mother's daughter and every father's son. We thank you for the widows, and we thank you for the offering. And we pray and ask these blessings in thy name, safe forever and ever. Amen.
Somebody challenged me last week about coming in church with pants on. We do not, we will not permit women to attend services in this auditorium at a funeral nor any other service in pants. If you don't like my way of doing, don't come. I'll still be on this corner till the Lord comes to get me. I know some of you won't agree with it. The world has gotten to the place now, I think the pants are material, but I think that there's something about the church that deserves some respect. that the world don't have. So we won't argue about it. And people who don't know and come here, the women are making some uniforms for those who want to come in and who don't understand. And they don't argue about putting them on. They put it on and come right on in. But you who don't like it, you don't have to come. There are a lot of places you can wear pants, anything you want to wear, but not at 43rd and Wabash. Lord, bless me. We can sing it without her. Sometimes we make a mistake. I'd like to say that I'm expecting every choir member present Thursday night to rehearsal, and every young adult choir member and youth choir member to meet me on Wednesday night at the rehearsal in this church.
Happy and prosperous New Year.